Yonte where you dey cry, my brother, my sister. 5 o'clock in the morning, and here you are, all alone. Brother, you've been so worried, you don't know what to do. Oh no. But I know someone who can help you, if only you believe. Oh yeah. The sun will shine in the morning, and darkness will go away. Oh yeah. So I don't. Don't cry. Don't cry. We'll go through. Jehovah Meloya. Chineke Meloya. Wipe off your tears, lift up your eyes, for the glory and the lifter of your head has come to take the burden of your heart.
Cross my head to pay from the cross to the grave, or from the grave to the sky, Lord, I'll lift your name on high.
We're going to bless the name of the Lord for a time like this. Bible says, in all things we should give thanks to the Lord, because he deserves our worship, he deserves our praises. Nothing takes him by surprise. Our gathering today is not a surprise to him. Give him praise for making us to be among the living. Bible says the dead would not praise him, and so let the living give him praise. May you receive our worship in the name of Jesus. May we commit this service into his hands, that he should come and take charge of everything from the beginning to the end, to send his spirit to guide and direct in all activities, that at the end the blessings will be our portion and the glory will return to him. Prayers in Jesus' name. And so, Lord, we bless your name this morning. We give you thanks. We worship you. Thank you for the life you've given unto us. Thank you for making us part of this funeral service.
We are asking that everything that will be done today should be to the glory of your name. In the name of Jesus. Those of us, Lord, who are gathered here, we ask that, Lord, your blessing shall be our portion. That even the ministration in songs, in words, and everything that will be done here, Lord, shall be a consolation to the bereaved family. And Lord, even as we'll be departing at the end of this funeral, we will go back with the blessings. Take charge, for we pray in Jesus' name.
Everybody now, for the last time.
Oh, yes, we got a yes. We got a river. Beautiful, beautiful river. That we the saints on the river. That flows by the spring.
Amen. That same spirit will take.
In good or in bad, we are grateful, God. oh God, for all you have done
for us.
Hallelujah, we are grateful. We say thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, for everything you have done. We say thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for everything you have done.
Now let's put our hands together for Jesus. Hosanna. Hosanna. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna. Hosanna. Hosanna in the highest. Lord, we lift up your name.
Lord, we lift up your name.
Lord, we lift up your name.
With a heart full of praise.
With a heart full of praise.
Be exalted, Lord, our God. Hosanna in the highest.
Everybody put your hands together for Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And everybody
Transgression and disobedience receive a just recompense of reward. How shall we escape if we neglect so great salvation, which at the first began to be spoken by the Lord and was confirmed unto us by them that heard him? God also bearing them witness, but both with signs and wonders, and with divers miracles and gifts of the Holy Spirit according to his own word. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
To him will he find us watching with our lamps all trimmed and bright.
Watching girl, say we are ready, brothers, ready for the soul's cry home. Set heaven fire and be still with you.
Waiting
when the Lord
shall come. I want to hear the congregation now. What is the congregation?
Souls bright home. Say we define you and me still watching, waiting.
We'll take it again.
Waiting when the Lord shall come.
For the last time, everybody.
Oh, shall we say we are ready, brother, ready for the souls bright home. Say we'll define you. We still waiting, waiting, waiting when the Lord shall come.
Amen. Because I grew up to have two sisters and a brother. But now I am left with none. I thank God. I thank God when I heard that my sister was in this place. I came down from Lagos 10th of January to see my sister. She was relatively improving. And we had come to a covenant when we lost our other sister that we would go as we came. So I thought when my mother left, I should be the next to go. But thank God that she has taken my sister. But what I'm thanking God today especially is that before she left, she has made her peace with God. During our conversation, she told me, she thanked me for some phone calls I made to contact her during the sickness. Specifically, she told me that she has begged God to forgive her sins and that God has forgiven her sins, that she is so happy. So I am thanking God that she has left the problems of this world to rest with Jesus. And by the grace of God, one day, I will see her to pardon me.
Personal reflections on the life of Mrs. Ian Thompson. I title it An Angel Slipped Away. The great robber and thief, death, the world's worst and most shameless, unwanted, never invited and meanest guest, the cursed, untiring fiend, has again raised his monstrous broken head, and this time, most painfully, robbed the world of one of her greatest daughters, Mrs. Ian Thompson. What a wonderful, sweet and gracious sister she was. How I wish I were a poet and have the poetic license that could invent words and phrases yet unused to write the song of your rich but short life. How I wish I were a better writer who can put words together better than Shakespeare or Wordsworth could construct a beautiful edifice of your glorious life so that the literary feats of all of Oxford scholars would pale into insignificance. Unical scholar has hastened past all the transient things of this short life. She well knew she was just a stranger on earth. Who could she help in any way? And she passed on. an industrious, faithful, sacrificial, and helpful wife, mother, and relative. UBS banker and faithful manager of human resources, always carrying an infectious smile even when dog tired. If she were a trillionaire or even a billionaire, poverty would have been stamped out of this selfish world by now. A meek, compassionate lady whose compassion was deeper than the Calabar River. She had no room for hatred, malice, or rancor. She would part with her gold in pursuit of peace. Too innocent to do evil, yet Satan and his cohorts did not care. In fact, it is the better a soul, the greater the hatred. If any man or woman has had any part in her ordeal, it was better he or she was not born. But what would they tell God she did to them? Shameless death, where is your sting now? The young is free from your grip and harm for good. I am thoroughly ashamed and weep that all my purported learning has failed woefully to bring out half of the beauty of your great life. Goodbye, my dear. Await me beyond this veil of tears. Tears well up in my eyes now, and they burst forth and rush down my sunken cheeks. They are hot, having been bottled up since I learned about your demands. I am proud and very happy to realize I'm able to shed these tears for you. Yet I am not ashamed. I am bitterly crying. I miss you so much.
And colleague, a senior colleague who passed on, and I'm standing by the special grace of God because my heart is broken right from the day I heard of her demise. Somebody has said here when we were worshiping God that we have a friend that is closer and sticker than a brother. And because Inyang had Jesus Christ, that is the only consolation that I want all of us to have. That she has found a better place. And she's away from this wicked world. In the name of Jesus Christ. Inyang, my Inyang, or Mati, as we fondly called her, was a doyen of peace. She was a home of chastity. The time was that I walked directly under her, a focal person as it has to do with adherence and counseling in the department or special clinic. I have condolence messages here that I had to go around. People wrote to console the family and every one of us because of who Inyang was. A peaceful woman, a woman of God. One of it, because I have to acknowledge the people took pains to do it, though we couldn't capture it here in the program, but we have them here. One came from Dr. Koi Nta, the head of Department of Family Medicine, University of Calabar Teaching Hospital. He gave it to me and I sent it to the family, and they have acknowledged. I want to acknowledge it here. Inyang works in special clinic under family medicine, in UCTH. Another one came from the special clinic monitoring unit. Came from my beloved sister, the head of department, Mrs. Janet Ebrey. She gave it to me and I handed it over to the family. The other one came from the Senior Staff Association we call South Tribe, where she was a member. It can be contained here. The last but not the least, because the one from our parent department is already in the program, which we couldn't do without. It has to be here. He has worked in the Department of Medical Social Services in UCTH. So this one came in yesterday, I was given, I took it to the family and I was handed this morning from Medical and Health Workers Union of Nigeria. Inyang was a member. Let me read this one, permit me, ladies and gentlemen, to Mr. Edith Ben Thompson, number 9, Poultry Farm Road, Calabar. Condolence message. The executive and members of Medical and Health Workers Union of Nigeria, Mahun, UCTS branch, wishes to convey her deepest condolences to you and your family
over the demise of your beloved wife, late Mrs. Inyangede Thompson. We encourage you to derive strength from the fact that God has called her unto himself. He knows what to do with her. The entire union share in your irreplaceable loss and pray that the Heavenly Father, whose life originates from, to rekindle your faith in him and grant her soul eternal rest. Amen. Please accept our deepest condolences. This is signed by Comrade Patrick Itapang as the chairman, and then Comrade Boniface Otu, the secretary. Thank you very much.
54 years.
My young lady, she was foully called, was born in an FNDU on July 6, 1967, in Enugu, to the family of late Mr. Ekwe, Udiyo Ekwe, of Mbarakon, Creek Town, in Odupani Local Government Council of Cross River State. She had a primary education at Charles Walker International School, Convent Primary School, and Hillside International School, from where she proceeded to the Federal Government Girls College, Calabar, in 1980. After her secondary education, she got a job with the United Bank of Africa, PLC, as a clerical officer, where she grew to the position of assistant manager and voluntarily resigned in 2006. While in the bank, she registered for the diploma in Business Administration program of the University of Calabar in 1990 and graduated in 1992. In 1999, she was admitted into the social work program of UNICAL and obtained her bachelor degree in 2004. Her quest for further knowledge led her to obtain her, Her quest for further knowledge led her to once again seek admission into the university, where in 2015 she obtained a master's degree in public policy and administrative studies. In October 2009, she joined the University of Calabar Teaching Hospital as a medical social worker and served in the capacity until her death. For her hard work and commitment, she received several awards, including a letter of commendation from the then Chief Medical Officer, Professor Agan, and also a letter of commendation from the Institute of Social Works of Nigeria. She was an associate member of the Chartered Institute of Local Government and Public Administration of Nigeria, and an associate and licensed social worker of the Institute of Social Work of Nigeria. She had some health challenges which she battled through the years until the Lord decided to call her to rest. She obeyed the call. She was married to Mr. Eddie Ben Thompson, and the marriage was blessed with a daughter and a son. Mayim was born into a Christian family, and she kept her faith throughout her lifetime. She was a member of the Prisons Fellowship of Nigeria, and also served the Lord in many other capacities. She will be dearly missed by all who knew her. She is survived by Mr. David Ben Thompson, the husband, Mrs. Blessing.
There will be joy in the morning. There will be joy in the morning. Oh, child of God, cry no more. There will be joy in the morning.
Right. The Bible confirms that there is time for everything. Praise the Lord. A time to weep and a time to laugh. Our prayers and advice, encouragement, is that while we are crying, we should cry as believers.
Who has supported us in one way or the other, especially during the very trying time of our illness.
for finding time to share in our grief as we pay our last respects and lay her remains to rest. We pray that the Almighty God reward you immensely. In Jesus' name. Special thanks goes to the Church of God Seventh-day Nigeria for the prayer, support, and anchoring the obsequies. We also thank the staff of the Social Medical Department of the University of Calabar Teaching Hospital for the love, concern, and prayers. As you return to your various destinations, may the Lord's presence go with you, and may He guide your footsteps safely to your loved ones. Miss David Ben Thompson for the bereaved family. Praise the Lord.
Worried whether it is brief or long. But when it is the word of God, make it very short, very brief. I'll try to be brief. That is why I have placed my watch here. I am timed so that I know when to stop. But for God's sake, I want you to respect God and listen to what you are going to hear, because God is going to hold you accountable for what you have heard today. I want to read from the scriptures where that brother read for us, Hebrews chapter 2. Only the first four verses. If you don't have your Bible with you, please listen to this reading. Therefore, we ought to give the more earnest heed to the things which we have heard, lest at any time we should let them slip. 2. For if the word spoken by angels was steadfast, and every transgression and disobedience received a just recompense of reward. 3. How shall we escape if we neglect so great salvation, which at the first began to be spoken by the Lord? and was confirmed unto us by them that heard him. 4. God also bearing them witness both with signs and wonders and with diverse miracles and gifts of the Holy Ghost according to his own will. The topic of our meditation this morning is a question which I want you to take home. And the question is, have you received the great salvation of God? I repeat, have you received the great salvation of God? My brothers and my sisters, I'm not asking whether you go to church. Going to church doesn't change anything. I'm not asking whether you belong to any church. I am asking you whether you have received the great salvation of God. The portion we read makes us to know that God has provided great salvation for you and for me. And you see that in the first scripture that you learnt while you were young. John chapter 3 verse 16, which everyone can quote. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever, if Emmanuel Eden believes, if you believe, if the smallest believe, if the greatest believe, if chiefs believe, if governors believe, they should not perish, but have what? Everlasting or eternal life. The question is, have you got that life? It is possible to pass through the mere motions of Christianity, from this activity to that activity, from this activity to that activity, and you have not gotten the great salvation that God gives. How the years run. I remember when I was 25 years working at a radio station. One day, my director looked at me. I used to be very neat, and he commended. I said, Emmanuel, you look good. You are cute. You are neat. Look at me today. 25 years ran past. Then 30, before I knew it 40, before I knew it 50, before I knew it 60, and now I'm above 60. My days are going. Your days too are going. Whether you believe it or not, our days are going. Every second, our days are going. But the devil still makes us think we have many years. If Ian was asked 20 years ago, when would you like to die? I believe with all my heart, she wouldn't have said 54. I believe with all my heart, she wouldn't have loved her elder sister to outlive her. So what are you sure about your life? What are you sure about your life? What are you sure about your life? We do a lot of planning. Plan A and plan B. If this one fails, I'll do this one. If this one fails, I'll do this one. My friend, are you sure you'll be alive to do it? Or even if you're alive, we live in a world of change. Many things change. A world of change. Even we ourselves, physically, we are changing. A lot of us are so proud of our good looks. So proud of our youth. And then we forget that God says even youth the beauty that you see are all transient. You think I looked like this? Don't you think there was a time that I was dandy? Dandy, cute, smart, no pain anywhere. But there are some things I cannot do anymore. There are some loads I cannot carry anymore. I don't want to break my waist. My years are going.
How I dear God. He doesn't say the condition is bring your father, bring your wife, bring your daughter, bring your relatives, let your head of the family sign, let the local chamber, local government chairman sign. Priceless. Priceless. Gratis. Free. And then you don't receive a salvation like that. And then it's time to die and you die. And appear with Jesus with all your sins. And then they will ask you, did you know Jesus? You said, yes. You know Jesus and you are not saved from your sin? Are you saved from your sin? Do you know, have you received the great salvation of God? Do you know how the blood of Jesus breaks every bitter? You know, you say, you don't know the sin binding me. I've been a fornicator all my life. I can't see how I can quit it. The worst of fornicators, the worst of adulterers will make heaven. Then they will condemn you. Say, if fornication torments you more than me, you say, I steal a lot. Do you know how I stole? Do you know what I was addicted to? Do you know what I was addicted to? Stealing, eatable things. I didn't pity my mother's fish or meat. And the poor woman will call me and will say, Emmanuel, the way you are stealing, they will put you on drug and shoot you to death unless you repent. But thank God for the great salvation. Salvation, Jesus' salvation can change you, can make you a new person. Have you received it? The great salvation of God. You can receive it today. Please listen, listen, listen. Please listen. Dear God, give us time. I was to preach 20 minutes and I'm not going beyond that. But for now, please, dear God, pay attention. Pay attention. Have you received the great salvation of God? You can have it today. I don't say go and pray at home. I don't say you can go to church and receive it. I say God's salvation is so great that God can give it to you now. Everything has been made ready. If you like, come. If you like, receive. God will not force you. He has given you a free will. And He knew you will come here today. Have you spawned the salvation of God? You can receive it today. Listen to me. Your church is not going to change you. Your church is not going to help you. It is not a church party. I don't belong to the church where this lady finally worshiped. And thank God, people around him know that salvation is a universal business. There is not going to be a church in heaven. Those who are washed by the blood of the Lamb are going to be raptured out of this world to meet Jesus who died for them. Jesus will not mind whether you were Catholic or whether you were Methodist, or whether you were apostolic faith, or whether you were this or that. What matters is receiving the great salvation of God. Rise to your feet. Have you received the great salvation of God? You want to receive it now? We have done a lot of praying. We begged the God of heaven. He said, no matter how that person is entrenched in sin, no matter what his past experience has been, provided the person lifts up his eyes and said, Jesus, have mercy on me. Come into my heart. Do a work of grace in his or her life. Shall we close our eyes and pray? You need the salvation of God. Because on that eternal day,
close your eyes and pray.
Young people, you feel so proud, so full of yourselves, you're dead. Divine Mother, say that to you. Be warned. Be warned. Please pray this one. All these souls standing before you, you know all of us where we are. You know the few here who have received this great salvation, and you know those who have not received. I plead with you, great Holy Spirit, talk to everybody here. Draw us unto yourself, so that when we leave this world, we don't become guilty of the salvation you provided, which we refuse to have. Have mercy upon us. Bless all this your people to the glory of your great name. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Grace, God's grace, grace that is greater than all I've seen.
Afonande, ue mi edi, mboto Jehova, afomodo itoro, o itoro, tafonande, ue mi edi, mboto Jehova, afomodo itoro,
Jesus Christ, never fell me.
There is nothing I know, wherever I go, Jesus Christ, never fell me. He's never fell, never fell me. Jesus Christ, never fail me.
There is one thing I know,
there is one thing I know, wherever I go, Jesus Christ, never fail me.
For these ones, the Lord should comfort them, should console them. He promised to be a mother to the motherless. He said he will take care of them, that the Lord should perfect his will in their lives. At the end, Brother Stephen Eshet will pray for the family.
And yet I get it any better than my mommy, but that's a good food. That's a good. That's what I have a good call. I tell them angels. I guess send them mommy go who be a good fact. You know, I need your good one in a mom. So that's a good.
His rise, he became to be with this family to console them. And as they are, we are surrounded them. It is as the Lord is surrounding them with angels. The prayers can become a canopy over them. The
prayer can become a consolation to them. Maybe you came not with offerings, what to offer. Your prayer is the best offering for this
one.
Sing this song with me.
Oh, bong sin mi ke ka u bo fo. Ku ya ge mo bong mi. Oh, sa ma ang bo ji dem no. Ke bo a fo di o bong mi o. Oh, bong sin mi ke ka u bo fo. Dem bo ku ya ge mo bong mi.
Sudah di fobunang kami ya, Pak. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Mbok abasi. Baku sentem. Ekonomi lonka motwa. Kini berenduk motwa. Niki anoy okwa manemene woro. Ndung kesin kinte wede. Kinte ma wede rege. Sometime I was like you. I mean there, eh? Nyung anoy okwa mante sen kuri ekop emene woro. Nge yung nibong woro kisho tup. Mpyankre nora raito kisho tup ete. Very soon you will join me. Woro mindare minte wufungpa. Mekebe ni nyong at any time. Et il m'a dit, mais moi, il fait mon team parafi. Man, vous êtes marié, young de. Faut pas la mousse, le couvre.
Vous
y a même moi, comme il est marié, mot, et ta kéri, mot. Pour faire ma tête, je vais vous dire, 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 je vais Mbok abasi. Koriowo nommo. Kerieke nommo. Kerieka nommo. Jagdiye yeneka nommo.
Amen.
Amde mo esure. Ibereka mo esure papa mbok. The lost mbok jak dong yoko.
In pogi mai kamake ni bat. So best is going to go. Ini nam kan tengi ni bangare.
Amen. Please, if the representative of the family should step forward. I bless this in the name of Jesus. On behalf of this congregation, I present this to you in Jesus' name. Say with me that I remember, and I say in Jesus' name. Let the person in the ark of me be counseled in the name of Jesus. Go in Jesus' name.
Thank you. Can we encourage her, please? The Lord bless you.
Last respect to our friend and our sister. So we'll have a condolence to read, and then we'll just sing our anthem to bid our sister farewell. Thank you.
Pegoka class of 85, stronger together. Mr. Eddie Thompson, number 9 Poultry Farm Road, New Airport, Calabar. Condolence message. The FGTC Calabar class of 85 received with shock the sad news of the demise of your beloved wife, mother and sister, late Mrs. Inyanyade Thompson. We share in your grief, but call on your entire family to take solace in the fact that she was a good woman whose legacies will live on. Please accept our condolences. To our dear sister and friend Inyang, we didn't get to say goodbye. We didn't get to say farewell. For you have been suddenly taken from us. So many things have been left unsaid. So many tears will still be shed. Our hearts ache and grieve. You will be sorely missed. For 5 precious years, we ate from the same pot. We played, studied, and bonded together. We became your sisters. We are here today, standing strong together, to wish you a peaceful rest in God's hands. Sleep on, our beautiful sister, never to be forgotten. Adieu, Sister Ian, till we meet to part one more.
Thank you.
From north, south, east, and west, we come to FGGC Calabar with honor and loyalty. Yield ourselves to thee to mold and rule. Rolling land of pleasant memories, country grounds of feminine graces, we adore and make this promise to shine for thee.
Amen.
Do with me,
was filled. Fill me with grace, fill me with God, be with you till we meet.
Let me hear the congregation.
Till
we meet.
Till we meet. Till we meet at Jesus' feet.
Till we meet.
Till we meet. Till we meet. God, be with you
till we meet. Only the sisters.
Till we meet, till we meet, till we meet at Jesus' feet. Till we meet again, till we meet. God be with you till we meet.
Let me hear the brothers.
Till we meet, for me, till we meet. Till we meet at Jesus' feet. Till we meet, till we meet again. Till we meet.
Everybody now with the instrument.
Till we meet. Oh, till we meet. Till we meet. Till we meet at Jesus' feet.
Has happened and what we have done and what you have done. Father, we cannot change this event because you ordained it so. But I'm praying, oh Lord, as we remain in this life, make us faithful. May we become faithful unto you. May we believe in Jesus Christ. May we hope for the salvation. May we hope for the coming kingdom. May we think about the resurrection of the dead that you will bring about when you will bring down the Messiah from heaven. I pray, oh Father, that you bless all the souls that have come in here to witness and partake and appreciate and also console those who are bereaved. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Now, oh Lord, I'm asking, as your children will be going back, lead them safely well. Give them journey mercy. Let them not fall apart. Father, lead them, care for them, provide for them. And also Yahweh, the great Father in heaven, give your personal reward to all them that came in here to share with the bereaved brethren. I call upon the Yahweh to bless this assembly in the name of Jesus Christ. Take glory, O King, because you have done it. May your name alone be glorified, for I pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
The beautiful, the beautiful. Till today, it takes only the Holy Spirit to understand what they are passing through. We pray God should heal them.
Amen.
And that God should make that hope brighter in our hearts. That a day is coming that is going to wipe all tears from the eyes of those who believe in Jesus. May He wipe from your eyes.
Amen.
May He wipe from mine.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Please invite the evangelist, man or son, to this grace before the covering.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Eternal Father, King of glory, we give you honor. We praise your name.
Amen.
We hallowed you, Father. You are worthy of praise forever. Who is there who is like unto thee? The scripture said, whatever happened, we should remain thankful unto thee. We are the works of your hand. What is going on now, you know before we. The scripture said, two important days. It's the life of the living. The day you come to this world and the day that you will go away. It has happened to our sister. We have no reason to question you. You made her to be here. And you've been taking care of her and sustained her up to this time. By your hand, all things are possible. And it has come to pass that she should leave us now. But the scripture said that the living knows what they should know is that one day they will go away. Yes, we were made of sand. You breathe into our nostrils and become the living soul. And now when the breath of life goes away, what remains is sand. And that is why we have to commit to the Mother Earth. So the sister has gone away. Father, take care of this place.
Amen.
And we are going to cover this place as we cover it oh Father, seal it by your name. And no power will rise up to say, let me go and manipulate and use it against the family. I pray, Father, banish us, I. And oh Father, bring protection to the entire family. But for the sister, oh Father, I cannot begin now to tell you what to do. She was your son. She was your daughter, sorry. And you know. But there is a promise for those that believe in the Lord that one day they will resurrect and live again. Oh, Father. Our prayer now is may she rest till when your son will come in glory. And when those that sleep will resurrect to life. Oh, Father. Bless all your children that gathered here. And as they believe in, oh Father, grant them joy, mercy, and speak for this. Thank you, Father, for answer prayer. For in Jesus' name.
Always, you will be part of me. And I will forever feel your strength when I need it most. You're gone now, gone but not forgotten. I can't say this to your face, but I know you hear. I'll see you again. You never really left. I feel you beside me. I know I'll see you again.
When I'm lost, I'm missing you like crazy. And I tell myself I'm so had you in my life.